Welcome back to The Rhode Show. This morning in The Buzz, we are chatting about the most important items in our homes. And it's an awful thought, but if you lost everything in a fire, what would be the one thing you would try to save before getting you and your family members out of the house? Well, according to a recent survey, one-third of Americans say it would be their smartphone. Who are these people? Second on the list, their pets. Next on the list was cash at 13% and jewelry at 11%. So if you were caught in a fire and you could only save one or two items, what would it be that you would make sure that you grabbed?
Well, first of all, when they say saving your family, I constitute my pets as family.
Right.
So thinking beyond, first of all, I don't know why you'd choose your phone
no,
over
I
your
don't
dog.
Either. Who are these people?
After my family,
right.
Two legs or four legs,
mm-hmm.
whatever they
right.
are, I would save pictures.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm talking, you know, old physical pictures that you can't get anymore, that are before digital, that's, you know, it's old relatives, it's
sure.
old memories. Those are things that you can't replace.
Right.
You can't replace
no, I agree.
A memory.
I
you know,
agree.
You want that there.
Yeah.
Anything else, I mean, yeah, is it a mess if you lose your whole wallet
mm-hmm.
and now you gotta call these places and get all your cards back? Yeah. But you can get them back.
Yeah. I mean, we always see stories about disasters, whether it be a tornado or an earthquake or something like that, that's come through someplace. And the one thing people, after obviously their family have gotten out, their pets
mm-hmm.
have gotten out, are pictures.
Yeah.
Are pictures, because the pictures just can't be replaced, especially
mm-hmm.
stuff before digital. Any photos of family members that you may have. I know even at my house, I have a bunch of things in big, like, bins. Just God
yeah.
forbid there was water damage or something like that, because those memories you can't you
mm-hmm.
just can't get back.
I think
you
bring up a good point. Even I think everyone has a bin. I have a
yeah.
bin that's just memories
right.
of things. Either
right.
you know a stub from some sort
mm-hmm.
of concert you went to or something. You know, and it,
yeah.
it's a little collection box of you know your high school diploma
sure.
or things like that that are just important to you
yeah.
and you want to hang on to those. But I think that's definitely would be up there on someone's list. We have a painting or I should say at my parents' house they have a painting that my great grandmother did, so maybe that would
of course.
Be, again, that would be something that you want to grab, something from your past that you just you can't replace.
Yeah, because there's so many things. Even nowadays, everything's digital, so a lot of people have it saved either at home
mm-hmm.
or other places. But even like old movies, people who have gotten married,
home movies yeah.
that you had when kids were little, if you have kids, and they were little, all those things. They once they're gone, they're gone.
Yeah,
they're gone.
Brendan, I mean, other than you know pets and your family, what else are you saving?
Well, yeah, I would definitely save my pet llama first of all. secondly, like you said, pictures, stuff like that that you can't replace. But most importantly, here's what our social media friends are saying today. Peter Moniz starts things off with his thoughts. My wallet has all my info in it. Of course, family and pets.
Nice.
Sloppy Joe had a similar reaction to me. Smartphones over pets? Ridiculous.
I agree.
Yes, Paul Stanley adds, I live in an apartment, so my first instinct is my pets, but I am willing to run back in for someone else's kids or pets.
That's a good point,
good
too.
Man.
Yeah, make sure everyone's out of there.
Very heroic. And lastly, Adam Thoreau says, emphatically and with authority, shame on those one-third, I'm saving my cat.
I agree. Text to them and say, you fool.
Yeah, gotta